Hi guys, bought this little car in the charity shop a while back, Gazillion Premium Bubbles. It's a little bump and go car that blows bubbles as it goes along, and I didn't need to do anything to it. It even had batteries in it, so when I press the button it works. But I thought we could take it apart and just have a look to see how it works. Now, most of the screws are these triangle shaped ones, so I've actually ground the tip of this screwdriver so that I can actually open these easily. I've got small adapter bits that will do these okay, and it will actually just reach in there. But I hadn't got anything that was long enough to go all the way into there, so I had to make my own screwdriver. First of all, we'll just have a look at the simple bit. The bump and go steering. Because that is very simple. The way it works is we've got a gear in there. In fact, that one's a crown gear, which means the teeth are facing this way. That just turns continuously. And then on the axle, we've got another gear. And that either drives round in circles, or if you hold it still, let's see if it'll turn. This is very similar to the way a differential works in a back axle of a car. So it tries to go in a straight line, but if something stops the car moving, then it automatically turns to a different direction. So that's the drive motor and the steering all in one simple bit of clever clockwork, I could call it almost. Gearing. So we can put that back together because we don't need to look at that anymore. Now, I'll take these screws out and we'll have a look under the bonnet. Right, something's holding it. More screws. Six screws. I thought there was only four. Looks to me like it's all driven off just one motor. This is the steering and drive motor gear. That's what turns down there. Obviously, this is the fan that blows the air through for the bubbles. That is an electric motor on the back of there. It's a bit tight, so it looks like we've got to undo the other screws as well. that's the reservoir for the bubble mixture. Gearbox assembly, but it's held in place by that fan blade. I don't know if that pulls off or not. Looks like I might have to take the rest of it apart. Oh, that's actually got a waterproof seal in it. Trying to feed some slack wire through so that that motor can drop out. That's better. So there we go, we've got one motor that's doing the whole job. So it's got a fan on the bottom of it that I can't get off at the moment, and a gear on the top of it that drives this gear chain. Which has got quite a few gears in there, which drive the bubble, whatever we want to call this thing, through that shaft and then through all these gears drives the bump and go steering mechanism. But that's the bit I can't get apart at the moment. I don't want to force it. I think we've probably got it far enough apart to see all the bits inside anyway. So we've got the on-off switch there. And one motor through a gearbox driving the steering, the bubble blower and the fan. What's the chances of getting it all back together again, eh? I'll have a rest for a minute. While we've got it apart, we can look at this steering and drive motor mechanism. We've got this spring-loaded gear here, and that's got, I suppose you'd call it a clutch underneath, a toothed gear. Hang on, let's zoom in. That's better. So we've got this spring-loaded gear, and then we've got a toothed clutch mechanism underneath, so that if it's forced in any way it can slip over the gears there, slip over the teeth. If I hold this still, then the wheels turn. And if I don't hold it still, then the whole mechanism turns and that gives you the steering. Right, I'm going to try and put it back together now. Got that the right way up. Yeah, I think so. Putting these wires back through. Right, try and remember to get the right screws in the right place. Most of them were all identical. There's only a few that were smaller. And that was one of the smaller ones. Better. Some little screws got to go down there. Thank you. test. Alright, that sounds like something isn't in place somewhere. That's annoying. That means I've got a gear wrong there somewhere. Gonna have to take it apart again. What gear did I get wrong? I think that that wire is in the wrong place, and that's causing a problem. That wire's in the wrong place. It's getting in the way. Okay. Let's move that black wire out of the way. that's better. So, which way do the rest of the gears go? That look right? Were you paying attention? That's better. Now see if we can get the screws back in. Not magnetic screws. Oh dear. Just put a magnet on the screwdriver to try and make them stick. Oh, just a tiny bit. Do it the hard way. A bit of blue tack perhaps. is just refusing to go in. Got it eventually. Just not lining up back either. That's better. Cool, these are a bit of a pain. Right. Thank you. got too many screws left. I've missed something out, haven't I? Have to watch the video back to see where I've missed two. Had to go back a step because I had too many screws left over. You can see I missed one just there. But I can't see any others that I've missed. It is possible that might have had screws on the table already, but I don't think so. Because these are all these triangular ones. One, two, three, four, five, six. Ah, that is right. Six left, so that was just that one that I missed. One, two, three, four, five, six. I like the way that wire hangs loose. Right, let's try again. Hopefully just six left to put in. Right, these are going to be awkward. success. I did panic a bit then when I had an extra screw left over, especially because I miscalculated. I thought I had two screws left over, but it was only one. So there we go. That's what's inside a gazillion bump and go bubble making car.